So, chances are, if you stumbled upon this video, then you need some major pointers for defeating Razor Hue, the 1995 version of Mike Tyson in Cyberpunk 2077. Well, luckily, I do have quite a few tips and suggestions that should help you with that, but before we get started, I do need your help in reaching 100,000 subscribers, so if you could leave a like and subscribe, that would be amazing, and let's get started. Alright, so for this guide, what I want to do is cover what perks you should have unlocked, what cyberware I would recommend, and then how to actually fight him, because I think that is probably the most important thing to understand. But starting with the perks, you really want to focus on athletic perks in your body category. For starters, Gladiators maxed out is a must as it reduces the amount of stamina consumed when blocking. This is going to be one of the primary things we're going to do in the fight, so again, it's an absolute must. Next, I would recommend Steel and Chrome, which can increase your melee damage by 20%. This fight is not meant to be super quick, and you're going to be chipping away at his health very slowly, so the more melee damage, the better. Next is True Grit, which increases your maximum stamina by 30%. This again is a must and should be maxed out for that 30% gain. Stamina management is going to be key to this fight as well, so again, make sure that you have this because it's absolutely necessary. Now, the rest is up to you if you do have some perk points left over, but increasing armor or reducing incoming damage is probably what I would recommend. But again, Razor is the Mike Tyson of Cyberpunk, and it doesn't really matter if you reduce incoming damage because 2 or 3 hits and you're probably going to be knocked out either way. Alright, so next let's talk about cyberware, and this is where things get pretty expensive. But the real question is, how bad do you actually want to win? What I would recommend is you have Gorilla Arms equipped and Animal Knuckles, which can both be bought and equipped from a Ripper Doc, or of course you can go to our fan favorite, Victor. I personally had the legendary version of both, and these did wonders to my melee damage output and added a very good bleeding effect to Razor, which helped chip at his health, like we stated in the beginning. Now, I have a video on how to get these, what you need, and more, and I will actually link that in the description below, so feel free to reference that for those. Now, last but not least, I want to talk about how your fighting and movement should be when actually fighting Razor. As we stated, Razor hits like a truck, so the goal of this is to never take any damage from him, because 1 or 2 hits, and again, you're going to be done for. Now, what you want to do is stand as far on the edge of the ring as possible, and keep as much distance between you and Razor as possible. This will cause him to run at you and do a Superman punch. Now, we only ever want Razor to do this Superman punch, and if you get too close or punch him too many times, he will start to throw some combos out there, and again, that will knock you the hell out. You only want him to do the Superman punch. Once he goes in for that punch, you need to block right away, and once you block the hit, immediately do a power punch on him, which will stagger him away from you quite a bit. Then you need to immediately follow up with 2 to 3 regular hits, and then back away to the corner or edge as he regains his stance. If you continue to hit him, he will push you away and could do a different melee move, and again, we definitely don't want that to happen. Now, you can also tell when you should back off by the way that he actually tries to get up and when he starts to turn his head at you. This is when he's going to start pushing you away, or he might try to do some whirling kick or turn around backhand slap. Again, it's going to be hard to block these. You definitely want to make sure that you don't get too carried away with the hits. 2 or 3 should be good, and then back off. Now, while doing this, you should also see that your stamina never really goes below half when doing this process, and if it does, instead only land 1 or 2 hits and back away. It is very important to keep your stamina at least at 75 to 80% by the next Superman punch he does, so you can then do your power punch followed by those 2 to 3 regular hits. You will also notice that your Gorilla Arms and Animal Knuckles will apply a bleed effect to Razor, so as you can see, every single time that I followed this process, I took anywhere from 2 to 3% of his health, and then I never even got hit once. Well, I guess I did get hit, but every time that you block, of course, you're not going to take any damage. So again, this is going to be the process that you want to repeat. Okay, so if you happen to follow these suggestions, you should be able to defeat Razor fairly straightforward. Again, it's just going to be a longer fight, and it's going to require you to make sure that you're timing these correctly, you're managing your stamina, and you're just chipping away at his health slowly. So make sure that you follow the process, rinse and repeat. Hopefully that was helpful, and if it was, leaving a like and subscribing is the best way to show your appreciation and stay up to date with new videos coming soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.